For those of you that have already watched one of my oblique hipped roofed videos, you would have already seen this plate layout. And as you can see, we have a unusual situation where we have a couple of corners that aren't at 90 degrees. So the oblique hip was one way that we can form a roof on this type of shape. However, the other way to do it is what we call a skew gable. So in this video, what I want to show you is the members that are in a skew gable, where they go obviously, and the bevels that we're going to need to produce to be able to cut a skew gable roof. So, as with the normal gable roof, our skew gable is made up of our ridge, lots of common rafters. However, this time we also have a couple of rafters which are on the angle or on the skew. And because we have these rafters on the skew, we're going to have something cutting into them, so we end up with jack rafters. That's our basic layout, and it looks a bit like that. Now, obviously, we're going to have to fill in the end, so we're going to need some gable studs, we're going to need purlins, we're going to need the ceiling frame, and everything else that we'd normally need in a gable roof. So that's the skew gable. It's a little bit simpler than the oblique hip, but you know, horses for courses. If you want this on the house or the client wants this, then you can go this way. So there's a few new bevels that we need to cut this roof, and a couple of old ones. So we'll go through the bevels quickly. The first one, obviously, the plumb bevel for the common rafter doesn't change. And the level bevel, the same again. So they're familiar. We also need to have an edge bevel for our creeper, as we have before. This one's going to be a little bit steeper than we're used to, depending on the angle that the skew is. We have to have an edge bevel to cut onto this jack rafter that runs into here, and also this one that runs in over here will be the same bevel. So then we have to have, because our gable rafters are running on the skew, they're a fraction longer than our common rafters, so they're going to have their own plumb bevel, and they're going to have their own level bevel, just because they're running that little bit further. And again, because it's on the skew, it actually needs to have its own edge bevel. So when it butts into the ridge, we have a bevel there to cut the end of the skew gable rafter. Also, that angle needs to be put onto the back of the bird's mouth as well, where it meets the plate. And the same angle can also be used for the end of the ridge just there. Now, important with this angle, it needs to be cut or drawn onto the rafter before you cut the backing angle. I'll talk about the backing angle in a second, but this angle needs to go on first, so just a point, always cut your backing angle last. Okay, and then number seven, bevel seven, is our backing angle. Now, what happens? Well, that's the backing angle there, and you can see it's in line with the rest of our rafters. Now, I've put a little block in here. See this little block here? This is a square piece of framing material without the backing angle, and you can see it actually would stick up out of the plane of this roof. A bit hard to see on this drawing, but if I just drop a line through there, okay, and okay, so you can see that with the backing angle on it, okay, that gives us a continuous line all the way through. If we didn't have the backing angle, we would actually have that much of our rafter sticking up into the line and, you know, disrupting our battens. So that's what the backing angle does. So that's a new one. And then we can go back. We've got our face bevel of our purlin and the edge bevel of our purlin. And there we go, nine bevels to cut the skew gable roof.